Very good evening, friends, and welcome to Trade Setup for Tomorrow, that is 10th Jan 2020. So first let us log into Trade Clue, which is a flagship trading platform and charting platform from tradingcampus.in. so here, if you already have the login details, just enter your email and password. If you do not have this, if you are a new user, then click on new registration and fill all your details. And without referral code, you cannot create your account. So in the referral code input box, type TC228. So TC228. Then click on submit and follow the further instructions. An OTP will be sent to your email ID. Just enter that OTP and then you will be able to log in into the platform. So let's go to the platform. So now today we have certain stocks and indices in our scanner. So first of all, the setup for Nifty for tomorrow's intraday session. So what we can clearly see here is there is max pain as well as daily support plus weekly support. So the best setup for tomorrow would be if the index comes down to DS plus WS, there you can accumulate all the long positions only for intraday session, and you can trail until the daily resistance. This should be your first target, and 12279 should be your second target. This is the best possible setup for tomorrow. Or else, now we know that 12296 or 12300 is the lifetime high that is achieved by Nifty till now, around 12300. So if you do not get an opportunity that Nifty comes down, takes a support near 12189, if that does not happen tomorrow, you can wait until Nifty goes to weekly resistance, which is 12279. There itself you also have this 12296 level. So there, try to look for any bearish position. So there should be a confirmation from a bearish candlestick pattern at this resistance level. If that happens, you can easily short the index for tomorrow's intraday session. So go long near 12189. If that does not happen, if price goes up, then either at the daily resistance or weekly resistance. Most probably, if the index goes to weekly resistance, there you have natural resistance as well as our weekly resistance. So our algorithm generated weekly resistance. So this is the setup for Nifty tomorrow. So bank Nifty, it is trading near 32,070 right now. That is the price level, and on the downside it has max pain level as well as the max call OI, but that is not the highest strike price OI. This would be the second highest OI. So 32,000 strike price is having the second highest call option OI, but that does not help us because call option OI we take it only as a resistance. Only this max pain will be helping us. So on downside it has too many supports, and immediately on the upside it has daily resistance as well as weekly resistance. So the best possible setup for Bank Nifty would be let the price go until 32285 to 32320, and there if you get any bearish candlestick pattern, then you can definitely be on the bearish position, and keep the final target as 32,000 for tomorrow. So bullish side, I do not find any good setups in Bank Nifty. It has to come down all the way to monthly support, only then it will be bullish. In between this daily support, weekly support, since there are many supports on the downside, you should always aim for the farthest support that you have, because from here to here, when the price falls down, it would have already exhausted its bearish momentum, and then there is also monthly support there. Along with that, there is also max put OI. So to go long, Bank Nifty should fall down until 31,500. To go short, Bank Nifty should go until 32,320. So these are the two possible setups for Bank Nifty as well. Bullish near 31,500, bearish near 32,320. Then coming to the stocks for tomorrow, one is Kotak Bank. So first let me show you what is the setup on daily time frame. So on daily time frame, there is a common high here. So definitely there are many short positions here, and by the end of the day, some have closed their short positions in futures. So a bounce back is clearly visible here, and this candle as well as this candle, if you see, there is a common high near 1662. So on daily time frame, if price can go higher than 1662, one can look for bullishness here. But on the upside, if you see, there is an immediate weekly resistance near 1670. So Kotak Bank will be a good buy above 1670. Above the daily resistance, okay, daily resistance is at 1670 and weekly at 1680. So it is good above 1680. So Kotak Bank is good above 1680, and at max you need to trail only until 1700, because there is max call OI. Because if a call strike price has an highest OI, that means it is going to act as a strong resistance. So go long above 1680 until 1700, and make sure you trail your stop loss as well. Only that is going to protect you on the downside. And then Mahindra and Mahindra. Let's jump to 5 minute chart. So mostly no resistances on the upside for Mahindra and Mahindra. So we'll try to look for bullish opportunities here. So just above today's high, one can be bullish. So today's high is around 542.45. So above that, you can try to be on the bullish side. Yeah. So Mahindra and Mahindra bullish above today's high. And even Bata also, you have a common high here, and the daily resistance is also somewhere around the same level. So what you can do is you can wait until the daily resistance, which is at 1763.4, is taken out, and above that you can go long in Bata India. And Bharat Electronics, even here you have a common high. If you just zoom in, so there is a common high today's and yesterday's. Again, 97 is the resistance that is being shown here, around 97.65. so above 97.65, there's no resistance until 99.2. this is going to be a good opportunity. There is also a 2-day high here. So yeah, above 97.65, there's a very good opportunity in Bharat Electronics tomorrow. So please give top priority to this stock. And the last one, Sun Pharma. So first, the setup on daily time frame, it has a common low. So what we need to do is look for any immediate supports, and below that we need to be bearish. So there is a 2-day low here, so you can immediately go short below today's low, which is around 439. So below 439, keep first target, book 50% at 437.6 and 50% at 435.5. Or else you can book 50% here, 25% here, and rest of the 25% you can trail if it goes down to 430. But out of all the stocks, BEL looks very good, because it do not have any strong resistance on the upside. And then M&M as well. because in Bata and Kotak Bank, you are able to witness these rejections on the top. So this is also a not a good sign for bullishness. Whereas in Bell, you did not see that rejection, and even in M&M also, we did not see that rejection. If you see the point of control, so most of the buying activity took place at this price level only. So for tomorrow also, this bullishness might continue. So above today's high, which is 542.45, there is no resistance until 550, which is more than 1%, because there you have the max call OI, which might act as a strong resistance. And within intraday session, if these positions are squared off, then this might as well go. When the stock goes higher and higher and it touches this, until that time, if this strike price does not hold highest OI, so then this also becomes invalid here. So keep an eye on Bell and M&M. Give top priority to these two stocks. And then even Kotak Bank also, above 1680, it has a good upside. Yeah, so these are the stocks and indices for tomorrow. Thank you all for joining.